Hi, this is Jeff at Magical Fruit Tuts. In this Photoshop tutorial, I will show you how to make a nice portrait of your dog, suitable for printing or framing. This would also make a good remembrance keepsake of a previous dog. This procedure also works well with black and white photographs. To begin, find a photograph or an image of your dog. Try and get one where the dog is sitting and his head is fairly large in the picture. It will make masking a lot easier if you have a plain, not too busy background, such as a wall or sky. Since you may want to print this image, the resolution should be at least 300 pixels per inch. Also, if you are photographing the image, make sure there is plenty of light and try to keep the camera about nose level with the dog. Load the image in Photoshop. For this image, I used a photo by Ashke Madan. There is a link to it in the description area. Double-click the background layer and name it Original. To crop the image to square proportions, select the Crop tool. Set the presets drop-down to a 1-to-1 ratio. Set the overlay options to rule of thirds. Then crop the dog's head and upper body as demonstrated. To avoid placing the dog in the exact center, I made his left eye appear behind the bottom right corner of the top grid of the rule of thirds layout. Click the big check mark to accept the crop. Next, check the image dimensions. Choose Image, Image Size from the menu. First, change the resolution to 300 pixels per inch. Then change from pixels to inches. Finally, change the inches width to a size you might want to print. Let's say 8 inches. The height should change to 8 inches also. Press OK to accept. Press Ctrl+0 to fit the image to the screen. Next, we'll establish the portrait background. To add a layer below the original layer, hold down the Ctrl or Command and the Alt or Option keys and select the Add New Layer icon. Name it BG Color. To sample our color from the dog's coat, press B to select the Brush tool. Alt or Option click over a lighter, colorful area of the coat. This will replace the foreground color with the color chosen. To fill the BG color layer with the foreground color, press Alt or Option plus Backspace. Next, we need to separate the dog from the background. We will use the Photoshop Select and Mask workspace. Because dogs have varying amount of hair and fur, cutting out the background can be easy or difficult, depending on the contrast, colors, or busyness of the background. There are many excellent Select and Mask tutorials available on YouTube. I've made a playlist of my favorites. A link appears in the description area, or you can click on the link that appears above. In this tutorial, I have used a method that works for the dog pictures that I have tested. However, choosing or photographing pictures with a flat or contrasting background is the best way for you to make the job easier. Next, to make a preliminary selection of the dog, make the original layer active. Choose the Lasso tool to select around the dog. Only select areas around the edges that are all dog, not any hairs or fur sticking out. When the end of the selection connects to the beginning, the marching ants will appear. Choose the Select and Mask option from the settings bar. If Overlay View is not active, choose View, Overlay, or press V. Set your opacity slider to about 37%. Next, we want to move the selection a little closer to the All Dog Edges. Select the Brush tool. Click the Brush drop-down and change the brush hardness to about 22%. Press Enter to accept the brush changes. Use the left and right bracket keys to resize the brush. Start painting the unselected areas of the dog, which are all dog. If you paint outside of where you want to, hold down the Alt or Option key and paint over the mistake. Now we have a pretty good selection of just the dog, not any hairs sticking out. Change the Output method to Layer Mask. Press OK to accept the selection. Save your work as dogselect1.psd. At this point, you can continue back to the Select and Replace workspace by double-clicking the original layer mask. When the Mask Properties panel appears, choose the Select and Mask option, and you will be returned to the Select and Mask workspace. Now we will make a run around the edges of the dog not selected, i.e. the areas not in red, in order to bring out the hairs, fur, and whiskers. Press R to select the Refined Edge tool. Increase the size of the brush using the right bracket key to where the brush is large enough to cover most of the areas not marked in red. Slowly paint the edge around the head and upper chest. Don't forget the whiskers. Switch to the brush tool and brush over any areas not covered that should be, such as the area below the dog's nose. When done, press K to see the results with the black and white view. If an area still needs to be covered, stay in the Paintbrush tool. This will act like a white brush does in a mask to bring back the selection missed. Paint white in any areas inside the dog's body that are black. If there are any white areas outside the body that should not be selected, hold down the Alt or Option key and paint over them with black. Press Y to get on the layers view. It's time to start inspecting for problems. To remove unwanted areas, hold down Alt or Option and brush over them with the brush tool. You can hold down the space bar and drag around the image as needed. When done, change the Output option to Layer Mask. Press OK to accept the selection. Close the Properties panel and save your file to dogselect2.psd. To clean up a bit, rename the top layer Dog. Next, we will add the white matting. Select the BG color layer, then hold down Command or Control plus Alt or Option while selecting the Add New Layer icon. Name it Matting. Since white is the background color, you can fill it with white by pressing Command or Control plus Delete. Move to the BG color layer. Press Command or Control plus T to open the Transform tool. Hold down the Shift and the Alt or Option keys while dragging in on a corner to make it smaller. Press the big check mark to accept. Once done, Command or Control click the BG color layer to select the colored border. Add a stroke layer style by clicking the FX icon and selecting Stroke. I used a stroke size of 18 for this image. Yours may be different, depending on its size and resolution. My stroke was black. You could experiment with other colors. Click OK to accept. Deselect the selection. To resize the dog, move to the dog layer. Open the Transform tool. Then to shrink or expand the dog as needed to fit nicely inside the background, hold the Shift and Alt keys while dragging in or out as necessary. Once resized, you can adjust the placement by dragging with the mouse inside the bounding box. The picture usually looks best if it is somewhat off-center. Click the big check mark or press Enter to accept. We will now apply a fade to the bottom of the dog. While still in the dog layer, make the dog mask active. Press G to select the gradient tool. Set it to black and white. Linear gradient. The mode should be multiply. By setting the mode to multiply, it allows us to make multiple gradient passes. Place the cursor somewhere in the area below the head and drag down. You can also drag down on the sides as demonstrated. Next, to place the dog's name, choose the text tool. Choose an appropriate font. I use Kandara, bold, at 48 points, strong, with the colors set to black. Toggle on the character and paragraph panel and change the tracking to 100. Toggle off the panel. Type in the dog's name somewhere below the dog and above the matting. Click the big check mark to accept. To center the text, select the text layer. Then, while holding down Command or Control, select the background layer. Then choose the Move tool and select the Align Horizontal Centers icon. Select the Hand tool, which will turn off the Move tool. Finally, we will enhance the background a bit by adding a radial glow to the center of the background behind the dog. Select the background layer. Choose the Gradient Overlay from the FX menu. Choose the Foreground to Background Gradient. Blend mode should be Soft Light. I used a radial gradient with reversed check, an angle of 168 degrees, and a scale of 93%. Adjust the angle and scale as you see fit. The idea is to have a slight glow behind a dog's head. Press OK to accept. At this point, we can reposition or resize the dog. Select the dog layer. Choose the Transform tool. Reposition and resize the dog as needed. Press Enter or the big check mark to accept. I've noticed that I missed some hair above the dog's left ear. You may have a similar problem, so I'll show you how to fix it. Double-click the dog mask. When the Mask Properties panel appears, choose Select and Mask. Press O or choose the Onion Skin view. Start the transparency slider at 100%. Zoom in to see the left ear area. Then drag the transparency slider to where you can see the missing area. In this case, I used 50%. choose the paintbrush at 22% hardness. Slowly paint back areas of the ear that are all dog, not the hairs sticking out. Change to the refined edge brush at 22% hardness. Carefully brush over the area of hairs sticking out. The output method should still be layer mask, so press OK to accept the selection. Fit the image to the screen. Close the Mask Properties panel. Here is the final image. Here's my friend Shiloh. This concludes the video. I hope you liked it.